All right, so for today's project, we are working on Angel's IS-300. And we're installing bucket seats. Bucket seats, there she goes. So we're installing Prisma NRG bucket seats on this one. And we're gonna pretty much go through the process. We have other seat brackets, but we might need to make the brackets for the factory seats work. So it'll be electric, pushing back and forth. So we're gonna see how that works out, and we're gonna pretty much go from there. And first we have to do is remove the seats. So remove the seats by taking out 4 14-millimeter bolts on each side, and this is what they look like. So I still feel like Angel said, it's pretty self-explanatory on what to do. So you move your seat up and take out the two 14-millimeters on the back side. Then you move your seat back and then take them out on the front, and then the whole seat will be able to move and come out.
So now that you have your IS-300 factory seats removed, it's time to work on your bucket seats, which in our case, again, we got the Prisma. So what we have to do now is attach our sliders to our NRG bracket, and then the slider, to this Corbo seat rail. No. All right, now, we didn't know this until we got it, but these Corbo seat rails, part number E2041T. Yep. They do not work on any other seats except for the Corbo seats. Don't know why, it's strange. I recommend getting the Sparkle brackets, but for now, we're gonna just drill holes a little bit offset, maybe like one right here and one right here, and then same on the other side to sort of get it to fit. And then we're pretty much gonna go from there. So the only thing you do is take your slider, and we want this handle here to pull up, so that when you're adjusting your seat, it's gonna pull up. So in order to do that, the flat side needs to be where the brackets are. And this side is gonna go to your seat rails. And then we're gonna put these on, and we'll start some drilling, and we'll call it. All right, so I got my first two holes drilled. I'm sure they're gonna go there. And I have some bolts here that came with the NRG seats. They're like 8.8 grade bolts with, I'm assuming, 8.8 grade nuts as well. And we got some lock washers and stuff there. So we're gonna put it on and see how well it fits in the front, and then measure out to do the same thing for the back. And here we go. And then now we're ready. Got the bolts on. Make sure they're real tight. I'm curious to see how this is gonna work. I did the other side and it seems fine. This seems like it adjusts real easy. I don't know, I'm just worried about it. This Corbo bracket ain't really shit, but it's working. I trust it, it's name brand, so I bet it's some good steel. And let's see. All right, guys. So as you can see, I got both seats in, and that's pretty much what they're gonna look like down there. And I gotta figure out what to do for the airbag and the light. So I don't know, I might just loop the wire or like get a resistor. They probably sell them online, but then just get your bolts in the back as well as those fronts. Of course, they're not tightened down just yet. And then I'm gonna figure out the torque specs as well. But for now, they look really, really, really good. I am happy. Hope Angel's happy. This is her car. My car will be next, I promise y'all, in all the videos.